Hey guys, so many of you have been waiting for this guide and it's finally here. It's gonna have a few parts because it's not that easy to explain everything. So we're gonna start with the first part and it's the basic one, the sensitivity. Well, sensitivity is up to you, up to your preference, but I think you should be able to do one 360s like this. So you can do fast turns. You could do, wait, it's important to do 180s, you know, like quickly turn, stuff like that. But do not make it that high. You also need to be perfectly tracking at long range. For example, if you have too high sense, it's gonna be really hard to track people with your crosshair when they be running over the field, for example. So choose something that is easy to aim at long distance. And it's also easy to do like 360s, 180s, movement like that, right? Okay, here you can see my settings, but you know, do not copy them, do not expect to be good instantly. You need to find your own. Okay, the second part. Well, you cannot get good without training, so you need to train. You can either train in training mode if you don't want to lose your hunter, but the best way how to train is play the game. You basically play the game. Shoot all AI, shoot the lanterns you see everywhere. By that, you will learn how to aim. But yeah, if you don't want to lose hunter, go to training, like I'm right now. And just go on the map, shoot grunts. You can flick, right? You can do like big movements, so you remember the muscle memory sensitivity. You can also practice tracking. For example, if you take Hellfire, you can throw it. Then you track the Hellfire and shoot when you think it's the right time. Let's see. It doesn't matter if you hit or not. The most important thing is that you're tracking the Hellfire. Right? You are tracking it in the air. You basically practice how to track hunters when they run. But yeah, the best gun to practice with is probably Windfield and Silencer. Of course, take Iron Repeater so you can shoot faster. And just go to training or a match and shoot everything. Shoot lantern, bells, AI, whatever. Shoot everything. Okay, so another important part is crosshair placement. So if you go to the building, you're not gonna go like this, right? You wanna aim where your enemy could be. So let's say you can hear him on the stairs. So you're gonna peek like this. You're gonna peek and watch if he's on the stairs. Like this. You can also watch here. Try to keep your crosshair in positions where you hear audio or where you think there is a hunter. So if I'm gonna peek like this on the ground. See? He's like that. If he pushed me, I'm just gonna one-tap him. With this pre-aiming tactics, you also need to remember where is the headshot level of the hunters. So how tall are the hunters, where is their headshot when they push. So as you can see, here is the step. So normally, the headshot level would be somewhere here. But if I go here, the headshot level would be stomach or a chest. So you need to aim a bit higher if you see it's like elevated area, right? So you need to remember where is the headshot level. But it's really easy if you learn it and you fight on the same floor. Because the headshot level is same, right, for everyone. So I think keeping the crosshair on headshot level is the most important thing, how to basically win most of the fights. Okay, there is two types of aim that you might wanna use at the correct time. So first, but basically holding angle. Holding angle is good when the enemy is pushing you, basically hold angle, watch the headshot level, and then just click. That's it. But be careful when you're holding angle. As you can see, your model is kinda blocking the view, so if someone crouch peeks you like this, you are not able to see him. That's one big weakness, but other than that, if you're holding angle, you're gonna win 90% of your fights if people just push into you. They can also jump, but you know, if you are good enough, you can adjust or just wait. The second situation is when people AD spam, so when they run like this, close to you, you don't want to track them with your crosshair, trying to shoot them like this. But you keep the crosshair at one place, and when they see, they go to the crosshair, you click. That's way easier than tracking them in the crosshair. Okay, and for tracking, you wanna usually track when people are at long distance or they are running in straight line. So let's say someone's running straight line here, so you wanna track him with your crosshair. Or when he's close range running, you know, you can still track him. But yeah, tracking is usually way more difficult than holding angle, because if you hold, it's just one click, you don't even need to move your mouse. So yeah, that's why tracking needs a bit more practice than holding angle. Okay, and the last tip how to get better aim at Hunt Showdown is don't play any other games. Because Hunt is unique. Hunt Crosshair is not in the middle of the monitor, it's somewhere below the middle. So it's like a really unique game, and I cannot think of any other games having this crosshair under the middle. Maybe like Halo, but every other game like Tarkov, CSGO, Valorant, they all have crosshair exactly in the middle of the screen. But Hunt is below middle. So if you play other games, your muscle memory and your headshot level in the other games will basically move, right? So yeah, if you wanna get better at Hunt, don't play other games. Because you need to get used to the lower crosshair and basically lower headshot level. Okay, this is probably everything that I did myself to get a better aim. And I just wanna say thanks for watching, and I hope this guide will help you at least a tiny bit. At least it will show you the direction where to go and how to get better. Of course, you're not gonna get better after watching this video. You need to practice, you know, you need to practice what I said in the video, and you'll get better, trust me.
Send crosshair, I think, is out of option forever.
Send crosshair at the moment is out of the question, because our weapons are aligning to crosshair position, and we want them to be less intrusive on the screen. We don't want the weapon to be high up. We want this it to be out of the way. One of the reasons why we introduced like the different types of aiming is just you can take more of the world in. Also, our gunplay is very different from other games, and I think it kind of helps with that. If at one point we give you a chance to center the crosshair in, like, decouple from the weapons, that's to be discussed, but it's nothing which is around the corner.